We are talking about the Dutch Peers trial. This is one of the classic trials coming out of the TCT 2013. It's a head-to-head analysis of two new stents, both third-generation devices. And I'm with Clemens von Bergelen, MD, PhD from the Department of Cardiology, Thorcentrum Twente. And that's in the Netherlands, just back in your country not that long ago. Thank you for coming to San Francisco. Let's talk about Dutch Peers, first off. Why did you do the trial?
Well, I think there has been a very significant improvement in stent designs. When I compare this stents, which we address as third-generation drug-eluting stents, they have the same coating and the same drug as the second-generation DES, which have proven safety and efficiency. But I'm a clinician, so all the studies came from clinical questions. So we use these stents, and we see a difference. We see the high deliverability of these devices. Before the trial was planned, I got a prototype of these stents in my hands, and I felt the difference compared to the stents which I had experience with. So I was very curious to see how that would behave in clinical practice.
So how many patients are involved?
The trial enrolled 1,811 all-comer patients. They were treated in four centers in the Netherlands, in Enschede, in Arnhem, Emmen, and in Alkmaar.
So these were all comers, so this should in theory give us some really good clinical day-to-day experience.
This is indeed the purpose of our study and of all-comer studies in particular. I think there are several all-comer studies in the meantime that have been reported. What is always important that there are that there is a sufficient number of ACS patients enrolled. And in the Dutch Peers trial, we had more than 20% of ST elevation MI patients and approximately 45% of ACS patients, which is quite significant. And I think that makes really a study strong in the sense of that you get data that you can trust on, really, that they reflect daily clinical practice.
So what did you find in Dutch Peers?
In Dutch Peers, our primary endpoint was target vessel failure, the same endpoint as in the previous Twente trial. We looked at the one-year outcome of target vessel failure, and we found that this event occurred in the PROMIS element stent in 5.2% of the cases, and in Resolute Integrity in 6.1% of the cases. And that has proven non-inferiority based on the calculations that we made before.
So how did you like working with these stents compared to second generation?
Very much. As I said, I am a clinician, and I got feedback from my colleagues. They are highly deliverable, and it makes a difference if you are fighting with a tortuous, calcified right coronary artery lesions, whether you can end your procedure within a reasonable number of times of time, or you have really a prolonged and difficult procedure. And we saw a difference, although we did not measure the time of procedure, for instance.
Well, we have seen such a difference since the 2006 ESC meeting, where there was the indication of more late stent thrombosis, and that led to the revamping and the second generation stents. Now we have the third, so it's really encouraging to hear data like Dutch Peers.
Yes, stent thrombosis is certainly always an endpoint that is of great interest. And in Dutch Peers, we found no statistically significant difference in stent thrombosis rates. The probable and definite stent thrombosis rates were similar. And most importantly, there were no definite stent thrombosis beyond 3 years for both devices.
That's really good. For the rest of the data from the Dutch Peers trial, please go to Lancet, which is online before print. With the Dutch Peers trial and with CardioSource World News, I'm Rick McGuire.